Students, let us do the remaining part of the chapter, that is transport of food and nutrients in plants. First topic is conducting tissues. Now, xylem and phloem, they are called as conducting tissues. Another name of conducting tissues is vascular tissue. Now, xylem and phloem, they are called as complex tissue. What do you mean by complex tissue? Complex tissue means that they are made up of more than one type of cell, but they work together as a unit and perform one specific function. Now, next question is that why xylem and phloem are called conducting tissues or vascular tissues? Because they help in transportation of water and minerals up and down the plants. Now, next, coming to the topic, that is xylem. Xylem has four types of cells. What are they? They are tracheids, vessels, xylem parenchyma, xylem sclerenchyma. Now, coming to the first element of xylem, that is tracheids. You should know the characteristics of each element. Now, tracheids, they are single-celled, elongated, dead cells. Walls are thick due to deposition of lignin. They have broad lumen. They have non-lignified pits. Next is vessels. Now, vessels, they are elongated multicellular tubes. Cell wall is thick, lignified, lumen is white. Next is xylem parenchyma. They are living parenchymatous cells having thin cellulose cell wall. Next is xylem sclerenchyma or wood fibers. They are long, narrow cells tapering at both the ends. They are dead cells with lignified walls. You should know the diagram of xylem elements. Now, one thing, students, that all the xylem elements are dead. Only one, that is xylem parenchyma, is living. That means tracheids, vessels, xylem, sclerenchyma are dead. Only xylem parenchyma is living. Next point is, the rings present in the trunk of an old tree are the xylem rings. By counting the number of rings, we can determine the age of a tree. Next, you must know the difference between tracheids and vessels. Now, tracheids are unicellular, whereas vessels are multicellular. In tracheids, the end walls are intact, whereas in vessels, the end walls are dissolved. In tracheids, the ends are tapering. In vessels, ends are rounded. Now, next, the tracheids, they have narrow lumen, whereas vessels have broad lumen. Coming to the functions of xylem. One main function of xylem is to transport water from roots to different parts of plant. But xylem has few more functions apart from this. Main function is conduction of water and minerals from root to different parts of plant. But tracheids, vessels and xylem sclerenchyma, apart from conduction of water and minerals, they give strength to the plant body. Whereas xylem parenchyma, apart from conduction of water, also stores food. Now, coming to the second type of conducting tissue, that is phloem. Phloem has got four elements. They are sieve tubes, companion cells, phloem parenchyma, phloem fibers. Now, coming to the characteristics of each. Sieve tubes, they are slender tube-like structures, elongated thin-walled cells. You should know the diagram of phloem elements. Placed end to end, and the end walls are perforated. by pores and are called as sieve plates. Next is companion cells. Companion cells. Now, companion cells are thin-walled, elongated cells. They are attached to the lateral side of sieve tubes. They have cytoplasm, large elongated nucleus, and these cells, they are living, they control the activity of sieve tube elements. Next, the characteristic of phloem parenchyma. Phloem parenchyma, they are thin-walled living cells. They store food and help in lateral transportation of food. Next is phloem fibers. They are sclerenchymatous fibers and they provide strength to the plant. Now, one important thing which you should know is that all the phloem elements are living. Only one is dead, that is phloem fibers. In xylem also you have learned that all are dead, only one is living, whereas here also all are living but only one is dead, that is phloem fibers. Now, functions of phloem. One main function of phloem is it helps in transportation of organic food from leaves to all parts of plant. Apart from this main function, phloem parenchyma helps in storage of food and mainly it helps in lateral conduction of food. And phloem fibers, they give strength to the plant body. And apart from that, it's also used for making ropes and rough cloth. That is, one main function of phloem is to translocate food from leaves to different parts of plant. But phloem parenchyma helps in storage of food also. And phloem fibers, they give strength to the plant body as well as are used for making ropes and rough cloth. Next, coming to the differences between xylem and phloem. Xylem. In xylem, the four elements which are present are tracheids, vessels, xylem parenchyma and xylem fibers. In phloem, the elements which are present are sieve tubes, companion cells, phloem parenchyma, phloem fibers. Now, xylem has all the elements of xylem are dead, only xylem parenchyma is living. In phloem, all the elements are living, only one is dead, that is phloem fibers. Next, the difference between xylem and phloem based on function. Xylem helps in conduction of water and dissolved minerals from root to aerial parts of the plant, whereas phloem helps to translocate food from leaves to different parts of plant. Next is nutrients. Now, nutrients in plants. Define nutrients. Plant nutrients are inorganic raw materials like carbon, nitrogen that the plants absorb from surrounding and utilize the same in building up their organic matter. Organic matter means like protein, carbohydrates. So, you should know the definition of plant nutrients. Now, plant nutrients and their sources. You will go through this. Next is, there are two types of plant nutrients. One is macronutrients, another one is micronutrients. Now, what are macronutrients? Macronutrients are those elements which are present in plants in large quantity. What are they? They are nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, calcium, magnesium, sulfur. What are micronutrients? Micronutrients are those elements which are present in plants in small quantity, like iron, manganese, boron, zinc, copper. All this. Now, next is importance of macronutrients. Macronutrients take part in synthesis of organic molecules like protein, carbohydrate. And what's the importance of micronutrients? They are involved in functioning of enzymes. Next, coming to this topic, that is deficiency diseases caused by lack of these essential nutrients. Now, one is chlorosis. Why it happens? It is due to deficiency of nitrogen. Now, what happens in chlorosis? Yellowing of leaves occurs. Next is the deficiency of phosphorus. Due to that, maturity may be delayed. Another thing is the deficiency of potassium. What happens? The brown spotting is seen on plant leaves. Next is, due to deficiency of boron, stem gets cracked. So, students, next day we'll do the exercise of this chapter.